gentlemen, we have some very special visitors here tonight. Can I have all you boys from the flight line stand up, please? These boys are all from Indonesia, because you're supposed to have maybe two kayaks called.
Hi.
And the kayak has to go all over. Heavenly Father, what did you send us?
Thank you.
ago the Maori Indians, the people of Whangarudu, Ngāti Wai, had a kind of a giant seabird that used to tell them when to plant the kumara, time to harvest. When the Māomāo and the Takahi were swimming down the coast, it would tell them time to fish. And when storms would come, it would say, "Hai e oki." And that would make the hope of storm coming. And when the enemies of the Ngāti Wai people would come and catch them unaware, this great bird would reflect their attention, allowing the whole people to form their battlegrounds. Those of you who have been up to that part of the world, there's a young man here who has flown all the way from America. Come on, John, stand up so we can see how you're doing. The certificates. And the doctor came all the way up from Dunedin yesterday to deliver, to hand deliver the certificates with Dr. Shirley Tonkin of Auckland. And this is all because of the song they sang for Kotte. So I think it's only right that they sing it.
Early in the morning, so we need it.
No.
There was one that brought the East Coast Maori people, and it was called Horotaka. Like all the great workers, they had to cross stormy seas. They had to battle with the great elements, lightning, the wailing winds. The Tanor, the albatross, wailing overhead. And when the seas were calm, allowing everybody to rest, until they reach Te Ko Māori or Aotearoa or Pailāpiti. Today the local people say that the waka is buried in the swamps at a place called Muriwai. Anyway, this is about that waka, Horata.
Whoa!